Dr. Devender S. Kawday.
Namaskar. Respected Vishwanath ji, Bhatkar ji, Dhande ji, the dynamic and visionary Mr. Rahul Karad, Milin sir, Chitney sir, Patan sir, Chopra sir, marvelous dignitaries sitting on dais, renowned academicians, dedicated faculties of this MIT, and very important, yes, good evening, you smart boys and beautiful girls. That energy was required. Thank you. So nice. Karad sir, I belong to an institution and I am proud of that NAAC, where we have a privilege to visit several universities like this and speak to the management and the students. And here with this experience, I would like to share with you that this is one of the best institutions which provides holistic development to the students. Now, related with the theme is very interesting, but slight my experience and feelings I would like to share here, that is, there is a need of igniting the stakeholders. Yes, stakeholders, I'm talking about stakeholders means. Stakeholders are the management, the principals, the professors, the academicians, the administrators, the students, the parents. Yes, to ignite the stakeholders of the institution to proceed more nicely related with the research, innovation, the scientifically oriented knowledge, wisdom, and holistic development. Yes, this is the fact that each and every institution in our country has, to some or the other extent, this concept of research, innovation, and some sort of holistic development. There is, but the proportion matters, and the proportion in somewhere it is like this, and in some institution at present which we are sitting here is tremendous. That makes a difference. Now the question arises, how to ignite this concept? And there are two methods, only two methods, which I can see and judge it. That is, number one, by rules and regulation, and number two, by inspiration and motivation. Yes, for rules and regulation, if we talk about, there are the regulatory bodies like UGC, AICT, then MCI, BCI, likewise. They frame the rules and regulations, and the institutions are there to implement it. And there are the bodies like NAAC, which assesses these rules, and the other ones like NBA, and the new one like NIRF. In brief, I will share with you about this NAAC concept and the present theme. Yes, we assess and accredited with specific theme like research, innovation, extension. We have a specific criteria related with the research, innovation, and extension. And then curricular aspect, teaching, learning, and evaluation, and very important related with the core values called institutional values and best practices, where we focus on specifically the core values, and we believe that that institution should not be in existence which does not move with this institutional values and best practices. It can be enlarged very nicely, but in next some other time. Specifically, I would like to share with you related with the innovation ecosystem, where which we are focused on, and there is some reason for the same, and why our Prime Minister also striving very hard that we should focus basically on creativity and innovation. I would share with you some facts. We have some 993 universities, some 39,931 colleges, and some 10,750 standalone institution, but we seriously lack into this direction. Specifically, some facts are there. In 2011, there was a comparative analysis of number of patents with the institution having, and we found that India stands in 17th position with only 5,100 patents compared to the Japan. Yes, we should compare ourselves compared to Japan, 2,38,000 patents, and that USA, some 2,24,000, and China, 1,72,000. So what? We have the schemes from our government to proceed that called Startup India Hackathon, and likewise they are moving ahead. And with a similar concept, we in our NAAC also have come out with the key indicators like innovation ecosystem. If it is there, some sort of meeting or some sort of committee should be formed so that the students and the teachers should be forced or focused on this creativity and innovation and ecosystem. We are straight away not asking about the patent. We are focusing on that part. And then one more thing I would like to push here from this stage, that any of the institution for that assessment accreditation, they have to go with three stages at least, not for for quality assessment. That is, one is All India Survey of Higher Education, then they have to move with the NAAC also. Then if it is a technical institution like this, some management institution, or some pharmacy related or architectural, they have to proceed with the NBA. So all the most 2 to 3 steps have to move ahead for any sort of coalition. See, the objective remains same for all these tools, but the concepts are different. So we can have that one nation, one data concept where one tool can be framed considering all. That is to extract the quality through the outcome-based accreditation. Specifically, the NBA is focused on that, but we are planning to make it ahead with this concept of outcome-based accreditation, where the students, the assessment can be done on the basis of students' outcome, institutional outcomes, and teachers' outcome, totally based on our present theme, that how we can ignite the stakeholders to move into this direction. And one very important thing I would like to share with you, related with yesterday, we have celebrated the 2nd October, and the second part, what I was talking about, inspiration, inspiring and motivating the stakeholders and how it is possible. One example that is related with Bharat Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, the propaganda done by our Prime Minister, very nicely it is being explained. And one example related with that, practical example I will share with you. And it is related with one of the very near kids, a boy who was 13-year-old when this propaganda started, and he found that in his school he was being explained, and such type of seminar conference were there. So what thing generated in his mind, in his behavior, was made a difference. So while traveling, moving anywhere, everywhere else, he just stopped throwing plastics or some any sort of rough material here and there. Even the littering and all that was being stopped. He used to oppose the things. Now, one very important thing, and this is something related with the youngster only, and two lines I would like to quote, and then I will stop. You youngsters sitting here, because there is an inspiration, thoda thoda karke inspiration aata, and that is essential that we should motivate our student. There is a word called dincharya, which has been given by Ayurveda to a humankind, and that states that what you do on daily basis, yes, take my words, my dear youngsters, what you do on daily basis, even though imperfectly done, will bring far better results than what you do perfectly but on irregular basis. This is so important, and this is related with your gymming, this is related with your yoga, this is related with your studies and everything, and this will make a difference. So I thank the organizers to invite me to make this possible from my end. Whatsoever possible, I have tried, and I feel that I have ignited the minds of at least the youngsters sitting here. Thank you very much.